In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Rguroo's random selection function to randomly select cases from a dataset. For this demonstration, I'm going to be using the dataset car data from the Rguroo User's Guide repository. If you would like assistance loading this dataset, please reference the video Importing a Dataset from a Repository. This dataset has 82 cases with 8 variables. Let's start by taking a random sample from the cases you see in front of you. From the probability simulation pane, select probability, and then click on random selection. This type of selection allows you to create any number of random samples of the same size from the same dataset. In the dataset dropdown, select car data. The sample size text box is where you specify the size of each random sample. The replications text box is where you define the number of samples to be taken. The replace radio buttons is where you specify whether a sample taken is to be with or without replacement. So if the option with is selected, then a case can be selected more than once. And if the option without is selected, then a case cannot be selected more than once. Now every time you run a random selection, samples are going to vary. To reproduce the same results, you would need to set a seed. If you'd like to be hands-on and duplicate the demonstrations in this video, set your seed to one of my favorite numbers, 22. Let's take a single sample of size 10 from the car data without replacement. Type 10 for sample size. Leave the replications box as 1. And then click on the without radio button. That's all it takes. Hit the preview icon to see the results. To reopen the data random selection dialog box, scroll over and click on the sample button. Now by default, a random selection is made from all cases in the dataset. However, you can choose to select a random sample from a subset of your data by using the text boxes in the section Sample a Subset. From here, you can specify the row to be sampled by either entering a sequence using the From, To, and By text boxes, or by specifying other criterion in the Rows text box using R syntax. You even have the option to use a combination of both. The Columns text box can be used to specify the desired columns you want outputted from the data by also using R syntax. Let's say I wanted to generate a random sample from the car data, but I only wanted to sample from the imported cars only. Not only that, but I'm really just interested in the variables horsepower and miles per gallon for those imported cars. To do this, I would first need to clear out the From and To text boxes. In the Rows text box, we would need to type the following R syntax: which, parentheses, capital, type, equal, open quote, import, close quote, and then close parentheses. In the Columns text box, I would need to type C, parentheses, 1, comma, 3, comma, 4, comma, 7, and then close parentheses. By hitting the preview icon, we now get a sample of size 10 from only cars that were imported, focusing on the variables horsepower and miles per gallon. Now the random selection function can be a great tool for getting a bootstrap distribution for a statistic. Let's say I was interested in seeing what the standard error of the sample median and the sample standard deviation is using 1,000 bootstrap samples. Let's consider this for the variable MPG in our dataset. To do so, we would need to scroll over and click on the Statistic button. Now, custom statistics require that you define a function in the text box in the center, and each function must be written in proper R syntax. The variables in our selected dataset can be used within a custom statistic, but keep in mind, each R function must only have a single value output. Click the green plus button to add our first statistic. Let's title this function Median MPG. In the function text box, type median, parentheses, then scroll over and double-click on the MPG variable in the right column, and then come back and type in a closing parentheses. Click the green plus button again to add our second statistic. Let's title this function standard deviation MPG. In the functions text box, type SD, parentheses, scroll back over and double-click on the MPG variable again, and then come back and type in a closing parentheses. We also need to click back on the sample button to clear out the text boxes in the section sample a subset. In the from text box, type 1, and in the to text box, type 82, so that we may randomly select from all cases in the data. Now let's set up our bootstrap parameters. For sample size, type in 82. For replications, type in 1000. And also click on the with radio button because we want to sample with replacement. We are now ready to hit the preview icon. And finally, to see the standard error for the sample median and the standard deviation of MPG, we have to save our output table as a dataset. I'm going to title this dataset Bootstrapped MPG. Hit the Save Dataset As button, and then click OK. Now that we have saved our dataset, scroll over to the data pane, right-click on Bootstrapped MPG, then select Summary. The summary statistic standard deviation for a bootstrap distribution is in actuality the standard error of that statistic. So the standard error for the sample median of MPG is 1.25203, and that for the sample standard deviation is 0.901679. Don't let your imagination stop here. The random selection function can help you do so much more. Here are some visuals I created to show the distribution of the sample median and the sample standard deviation of MPG. See what else you can come up with. To further explore the various types of R syntax used for creating a custom statistic, we invite you to visit www.rdocumentation.org. And if you would like further details and examples on how to use the random selector, we encourage you to reference the chapter Random Data Selection and Generation from our User's Guidebook.